John 6, verse 44.
John 6, verse 44.
No one come to me
unless
the Father who sent me draws him to me, and I will raise him up by the last day. Can you just read in your version? You say, New King James, James version.
Says, no one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day.
Just read in Amplified Bible. You say what?
It says, no one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, giving him the desire to come to me, and I will raise him up from the dead on the last day.
Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for your word in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I think the word that I was interested in Amplified Bible is the desire. Just write desire.
Two more.
That's what I want us to look at today.
I want God
to give us the desire. He says,
no one
come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, giving him desire to come to me. To draw is to give that person a desire to follow him.
Amen.
In fact, if we can look at that scripture,
it shows that
you can't follow God unless you are given the right desire from God. Because desire, it establishes steps to where you belong. Can you tell somebody say desire?
Tumo.
Is there to establish steps
to where
you are going.
When I
was looking at this verse, I realized
that
unless God gives you a
desire, you
won't reach the desired end.
Desire
to follow him
makes
you to reach the desired end. If you read, you realize that even in James 1, verse 14 to
15,
it says, each one is tempted and is dragged away and enticed to commit sin by his own desire.
It shows
that desire,
when
it's fully in you, it brings out judgment. That is James
1:14 to 15.
You are enticed. You are enticed.
We are
hukelwa or entertained by what you see clear. In other words, the reason why desire is established is because you so clear. You see, when you see clear, there's also what you are seeing you back. Your response to what you are seeing brings judgment on you. Can you tell anybody,
your
response to what you are seeing bring judgment to you? Look here, most of the time we have got many questions about what we want in life. And then we also speculate life and we end up having some attributes or concerning that kind of life. Because we are seeing life the way others see it. I can tell you that the reason why you draw a plan and then you want to see something
building you finish. It's because you saw something somewhere, you copy it. You end up having a desire to build your own in your own way. And working towards that plan counts a lot. I want to say that that's where desire is established. Some people, they just want the end of it. They want the results of it. But the way towards it, they don't mind. Some desires are there just to captivate us. And we end up in a wrong level. We can still have the plan of the desire and end up having that desire. But the way towards it makes us to receive a judgment. The way towards what you are planning, the way towards what you desire, is what matters. When God gives you a desire, He also establishes a path in front of you to take you to that desire. So many of us, we end up being tempted because we want to see the end of it, not looking how we can reach there in the right way. I believe today what God has given you, which is the desire, you will reach it in the right way. You won't be tempted on the road. If you believe, say amen. If you read Galatians 5:17, it talks about two natures in us. It talks about the sinful nature has his own desire to oppose the spirit. And the spirit opposes the sinful nature. It means in us there is a fight. There's a desire that has been placed there. But there's a sinful nature and the spiritual one. So there's always fighting towards the one that has been placed there. There's something that has been placed that you desire in life. Maybe you desire to be rich, but there's a sinful nature. There's also a spiritual one. You can be overpowered on the road by concentrating to reach where you want to reach, not looking on how to reach. Listen to this. Many of us today, we are in this sinful nature. And we found that already we can't reach the desired one that has been placed by God. God puts a desire and He set a destiny out of that desire of going towards the destiny. We must check if we are not losing our path. If you believe, say amen. How many of you want to be rich? We must be rich in the right way. How many of you want to build a house or buy a house in a right way? How many of you want to be blessed in a right way? Wherever you want to go, know that God will give you a desire. A desire. That desire, don't affect it by doing wrong. Check that desire. Sometimes we can call it zeal. That zeal in you can still make you to do things in the wrong way, to reach there in the wrong way. Or to reach before time. Because here in Christianity, God wants us to fulfill all the steps to our destiny. All the plans that has been placed on you, all the steps, you must be ordered by God to walk on them. I don't know if you're hearing me. Until you reach there, I can see the desire in you. And I can see the desired one that God has placed on you. In front of you is coming to you. I say, God wants to give you the desires of your heart. If you believe, shout hallelujah. If we read Philippians 1:23-24, you could hear Paul talking about the desire that was in his heart. He said, I'm pressed between the two, whether I leave you and be with Christ or I stay with you. But there is something that Paul said. He said, when I stay with you, it's for the benefit in your spirit, benefit in your soul. It's not that I'm here to take from you. He's saying that I'm not there to rob you, but I've got a desire which is small, is to be taken home, to be with Christ. Paul was saying, I'm no longer having any interest around you. There's a desire in me. Even when I'm around you, I want to impart you with what you have. I want you to receive what I have. Not to take from you. I don't know if you're hearing me. If we reach that level, truly heaven and earth will be fruitful. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
We will be fruitful in heaven and on earth. God wants us to be example when we are here. Example when we are there. I don't know if you're hearing me. It must start here. You must be fruitful here. You must be blessed here. Listen, you must reach a level where you are pressed. You are pressed. You see the importance of leaving this place. Because nobody will take anything from this ground in this world. So Paul reached that level.
I
said, there is nothing I can take out of this place. But as long as I'm here, I'm also pressed to do what God wants me to do. If we reach that level, we have got the right desire. Because the Bible says the people of faith, they saw a world. They desire a country that was there. They never loved their life. If you can read Hebrews 11, you will see that they desire the promise of God, what God has promised. They desire. Even the apostles, they were not afraid to die because of the desire in them. They had a desire that they were ready to die. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
So a desire can press you. You find that you are going through difficult times, but you tolerate. You could still not having something around you, but because of the desire in you, you find that you are carrying on even if there's no sign of improvement. There are some people who are listening to me. They can't see anything, but there is something in them. That thing in you will take you to where God is planning for you. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Can you tell somebody, say, my friend, I feel a desire to serve God. Can you see, you reach a level whereby people question why you don't sin, why you don't retaliate, why you don't fight, because there's something that is above any excitement around you. And that thing, it's a desire. Once God gives you a desire of following Him, what comes, what comes in your way, you don't care. You don't mind what people are saying. You just carry on because of you know what you are carrying. There are some people here, when I look at them, I can see you are still pressed by a desire. You are still, otherwise they were supposed to have turned back. There's nothing to show that they can even show that God is doing. But because of the desire of following God in them, they are not looking at the materials. They are not looking at the blessings. They are looking at what God can do, what God has given in them. If there is something in you, I want you to say amen. I feel a desire of following God with Christians who are ready to die for God, who are ready to follow God forever. I want to tell you that if you want to follow God in fullness, He must give you a desire. If you read 1 Corinthians 14 verse 39, that's why you will see Paul say, hey, you must have a desire to prophesy. You must desire to minister. There must be a press in you. Everybody is born to preach, born to talk. You must have that desire. But more so, a desire to prophesy. This will lead you to pray the more. Will lead you to fast the more. Until you see something. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Ask them, say, my friend, what is it that you are desiring that makes you to feel you can still do wrong? You can still do wrong and you forget the plan of God upon your life. Listen to this. In the last days, because we are in the last days, we have got only two challenges. One challenge is money. Money is going to make you to lose a desire of following God. Because money is there for show off. I mean, desire is for you inside. When you have a desire, it's for you inside to talk about someone. But money is for you to talk about yourself. It's a different thing. So this also can fight. I'm not saying having money is a problem, but I'm saying Satan will use money to destroy the desire of following God. Many of us, we need to be careful about money. I don't know if you're hearing me. Be careful about money. Devil will use money. Number two, devil will use people you trust most to destroy that desire. To destroy that desire of following God. You find that the people you are trusting, they will break you. They will break you. You find you can't pray the way you pray. You can't fast the way you fast. Always your mind will occupy with what they did to you. Listen, don't lose that desire. Don't lose that desire. Carry on following God. Listen to this statement. The desire that God gives you brings the desires of what God wants you to be. The desire that God gives you brings the desire of what God wants you to be. The moment when He gives you a desire, He says, be what God wants, be what I want you to be. He gives you a desire when you are following because of the desire. He's telling you, can you be what you want me to be? Be what
I want
you to be. Be what God, what I want you to be. The desire in you, if it's from God, is to channel you. There are things you will lose. There are friends you will lose. There are people who won't understand you. Don't cry to be understood. Don't cry for anybody. Maintain what you have. There is something in you. You can lose money, you can lose friends, you can lose houses, but don't lose that desire. Because it's taking you to be what God wants you to be. Let me prophesy you. This year, you'll be what God wants you to be. This week, you'll be what God wants you to be. I can see God taking you to where you'll surprise people, whether it works bad, but it will bring good things for you. Whether you are facing challenges, but God is taking you somewhere. If you believe, shout hallelujah. I see a desire in you. A desire in you. Don't lose it. Don't lose it. Carry on following God. You'll be what God wants you to be. Tell somebody, say, hey, I want to be what God wants me to be. There's a desire in me. Don't look at me. Look at yourself. Maintain the desire that God gave you. There's a desire in you. Don't lose it. But the things of the world. Listen to this. When God gives you a desire, it's for a certain reason. It means things are tough. Thinks there's no way out. When God gives that desire, you must be left with a desire. Only where you find that you don't have money, you don't have friends, you don't have desire. That desire is a petrol for you. I don't know if you're hearing me. I see a desire in you. That desire will make you a leader. That desire will make you a prophet. That desire will make you number one. That desire will make you a rich man. That desire will make you a kingdom financer. That desire that God put in your heart will make your name to be known. If you believe, shout hallelujah. If you read this verse in Psalm 145 verse 19, the Bible says you will fulfill. Psalm 145 verse 19, you will fulfill the desire of those who fear you.
Amen.
God wants to fulfill that desire. You know, once we talk about desire, it means you've got hopes. You are looking ahead. You know, God will never, God is not too late. He will never leave you. He is not even too late. He will fulfill. If you fear him and worship him in truth, he will make sure that what he put in you, it will come to pass one day. What I found about desire, which I want to tell you, when God put a desire in you find you are the only one who knows. No one knows. You alone, you know what God wants you to be. You alone, you know. And you know where God is taking you. And now, that desire is like a plan ahead that has been set by God for you. Something that God wants to do with you is in you and is written in you. You try to avoid it is there. You try to crush it is there. Many people come to you to drop it down, but it's in you. And you understand what you are facing. You are facing because of the desire in you. And that desire is in you. Your friends, they don't understand it. Your neighbor, they don't understand. It's what God wants to fulfill this year. If you are not known this year, those who think you are useless, they will run for help coming to you in the name of Jesus. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Say, I have a desire. No one knows about it. I found something. Listen. Once God put a desire, and once you are aware of it, and now you believe that God is about to fulfill it, you will see enemies. You'll just see enemies. You'll see people try to defy you in a wrong way. You'll see people try to oppose, to stop you. I'm here to tell you, this year you are unstoppable. I say you're unstoppable. What God wants to do with you, even your neighbors, even your family, even your enemies, everybody around you will know it. The world will know you around. If you believe, shout hallelujah. Sometimes God allows things to happen to you to stimulate that desire. I don't know if you're hearing me. Some problems are there just to stir up. Just to stir up the desire you have. Some things, when you look at them, you think they're there to oppose what God has given you. No, it's just to stir it up. To stir it up. You can still shine in that corner. You can still shine when no one is shining. You can carry on glowing where no one say you are in the dark. Let me prophesy, someone who's listening to me. God, this year, that desire you are expecting, God is giving you right now. He's giving you right now to be a blessing this year. If you believe, shout hallelujah. There's something that I was learning. I was just learning. I ended up realizing that many of us, once we follow God without desire, we become hopeless. Many of us, we are following God. You know, we try to be suspicious. Everybody become a suspect. Once you lose that desire, you have to point someone and say that one is wrong. That one is wrong. Do you know that the way you are, God has allowed you to be like that, to be born in that family. But listen, though you are born in a poor family, rich family, whether your parents fail to send you to school, it is not their problem. It's for your desire. Is for your desire. Is for God to stimulate that desire. If your parents were the wrong people, or you were not supposed to be born by them, today you were not supposed to be existing. So for you to exist, begin to thank God and know that the blessing is not outside, is in you. It's a desire that you were born with. A desire is a gift that God gave you when you were born. You cannot be separated with it. You cannot be separated with a desire. I don't mind what you are facing. Maybe you are facing all challenges, but you are not born for free. You are born for something. I say you are born for something. I want that desire to be visible this year. If you believe, shout out. Hallelujah. Can I tell you this? Whether you are facing challenges or not, allow the fire of God, of that desire to burn in you. You will run and you will never get tired until you reach where God wants you to be. I see someone at the end of the road. When I look, I see that God has blessed you. I can see someone who's here because of the desire of following God. When the winds were blowing, when people were opposing, but you reach at the end of the road, I said that road of suffering is over. That road of poverty is over. That road of shame is over. That road of sickness is over. Listen, what you need to do, what God has given you, He didn't give to someone. Whether you are failing where you are, it's for what is inside you. When they are talking about you outside, look inside you and say, He who's unto me is greater than the one unto the world. I'm not looking on my failures. I'm not looking on my past. But there is something in me. There is something that God gave me. And I will never lose it. I says, I prophesy someone. That desire. That desire. You are receiving it right now. I see God honoring you, raising you, lifting you. If you believe, shout
hallelujah.
Psalm 20 verse 4.
Psalm 20 verse 4.
The Bible
4.
Says, may he grant you your heart desire and fulfill all your plans. In other words, for you to be fulfilled in your plans, the Lord must be involved. The Lord must be involved. Listen, do not lean on your own understanding. The Bible does not accept that. We must involve the Lord in our plans. For you to carry out those desires, plans, allow the Lord to be involved. If you look at that verse 4, especially when he says, he will grant you your heart desire, not your eyes desire, not your mother desire. Everybody have got his heart, your heart desire. There is something in your heart. It will be visible soon. I want someone to be blessed today. If you are the one, say I'm the one. There is a heart desire. Can you ask somebody, say, do you see my heart? Ask your neighbor, do you see my heart? Can you see my heart? So don't judge me by what I'm facing, because you can't see my heart. You can't see my heart. Can you see my heart? Can you see my heart? Ask your neighbor, can you see my heart? Can you see my heart? How is my heart? So if you can't see my heart, don't ever think it's over with me. Don't ever think I'm finished. I can tell you this is the beginning, because you can't see my heart. Don't judge me by my past. The Lord is in control. If you can't see my heart, there is something I want to tell you. If you can't see my heart, God is doing a new thing in my life. Let me prophesy. Someone is listening to me. I say, what is in your heart, your family will see it. Your enemies will see it. Let God give you something that is in your heart. I can hear your amen. I can hear your amen. God wants to give you something. It's in your heart. And I prophesy you today, God is giving you something. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. Take it. There are some people here. I said, you will see your own feeling. Like what I saw. The Lord God wants to do something. He will give you the desire of your heart. And what you are searching, God wants to give you today. It will enter you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I say, receive it. I say, receive it. I said, I want God to give you a sign this year that you are not born to be poor. You are not born to die there like that. You are not born to be useless. I say, my God is honoring you. Take what is yours. Take your desire. Take your desire. Take your desire. Can you take it? Can you take it? I can't hear you. I can't hear you. Take it. What are you taking?
When out here, Manish.
What are you taking?
When out here,
what are you taking?
What
are you taking?
What
are you taking? I can't hear you.
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 What are you taking? When out here. Carry on. Take more.
Chia a holo sauce in yaka. Chia and toy in yaka.
I can't hear you.
I can't hear you.
In Jesus' name.